So donor-advised funds are gaining a lot of popularity because of all the benefits that they provide. Now, really, a lot of people thought that these benefits were only available to ultra-wealthy people or people who could create family foundations. But with a donor-advised fund, you can get a lot of those same benefits that the wealthy can get now. So take a look at this. Here's an example of what it is and what the benefit is of donor-advised fund. So let's say you're the donor over here. And you decide to give to a DAF, donor advised fund. You can give any amount you decide, and you can give out of cash or stock or funds or real estate, and there's even other ways to give. And the year that you give, you get a tax deduction, which is great. That's really the same as if you were to give directly to the institution. Why not just give directly to the institutions, the charities? Well, here's a couple reasons. Number one is, let's say that you're going to give a stock, highly appreciated asset. Well, you can, and let's pretend that you had multiple charities that you wanted to give to. Well, you could fill out the DTC forms and everything needed to give to those charities from directly from your brokerage account to the different charities. Or you can just decide, let's do it one time, get it into your DAF, and then once it's in there, you can decide the time and the place and when you want to give it out. So that's one advantage. Another advantage is, let's say it's a big income year. Let's pretend you give away 10K per year. And let's pretend this was a big income year for some reason. And for tax purposes, you'd like to give more than you usually do. Well, rather than flooding the charity with a bigger gift than normal, you could just give the bigger amount. Okay, in this scenario, you were giving 10, and now you're going to give 50. You could put in 50K out of any of these assets. And then over the next 5 years, you can have it spread out and sent out to each charity at the timing and however, whatever pace you want. So that's one other way, a little bit more control over of how it gets to these charities. And then one other big one is this idea of giving real estate. So let's say that you had a building and has appreciated in value. You can give a portion of your building to a DAF, and it gets converted into monies that you can then give out, which is pretty crazy to think about. That's actually possible. And it's pretty really cool to think about. But anyways, one of the other advantages, the reasons why I use it personally is one, yes, to give stock. But then the other reason is just setting it up on autopilot, where every month I can set up an amount that goes to each charity, or every year if you prefer that. And then I can let it go. And at the end of the year, I don't get three receipts, or however many charities you give to, you don't get those receipts. You just get one from your donor advised fund. So that's kind of a simple example of what a donor advised fund is and some of the benefits. I hope it was helpful for you. If you've got questions about it, really, you can go to, you can either give us a call, or you can just look up really every institution, almost every institution that you've heard of, like Vanguard or Fidelity or Schwab. They've got an option for donor advised fund. And then there's other ones like American Endowment Foundation or National Christian Foundation, or I believe there's a newer one called Charity Vest, which it might be a no fee donor advised fund, which could be interesting to check out. But any of those are out there. If you have questions about this, give me a call. But I hope this was helpful for you, and I'll see you in the next video.